team today. There are 14 first-year players and absolutely no fourth- or fifth-year students. So I think that tells us that the future looks pretty darn good for Trent.
Exactly. And then starting, you know, six first-year players is a big confidence booster for them and the team.
Exactly.
For the coach to say, you know, he believes in those players enough to start them.
And it's if anyone that watches and is a fan of this sport and this particular team must be well aware of the progression that this team has made, the progress. They've done extremely well. And I see something a little unusual today. Trent starting on our left side.
Yes.
Playing, they normally start on in the other direction. I don't know if tactically that is the reason might be for that. I don't know if they won the toss or not. But
it might be because second half they usually on that side play better. So maybe it's the hope that they play better the first half now.
Good thought, Brendan. Could possibly be.
Oh.
And we're off.
Oh, Shannon O'Brien down.
Already.
Already. Oh, that's not good. She's
a striker with great pace.
Yeah, she's one of the sparks on the team here.
She certainly is.
It looks like she maybe clipped in the face. Hopefully it's nothing too serious. We did have one injury yesterday that resulted in a scratch today. Carly Dunwoody's out with a knee injury.
Is she? I was unaware of that.
If you recall yesterday, she was limping around a bit. And
oh, yes, yes, yes. Is she dressed at all today, you know? Brendan?
I don't believe so. No, she's right down here in front of us. On the bleachers. Just right up here.
Over there, okay.
Yeah. So Ben is going off to get maybe some repairs done, so hopefully she comes back.
Hopefully, yes. So we'll be playing shorthanded. Is there no reserve come in?
No. So that says to me that it's not a serious injury, just something that a few minutes get patched up and send her back. Oh, sorry. Correction. There's a reserve player coming on now. So it's something a little bit more serious, maybe.
Emily in again. Emily Larkin in again.
Oh, actually, Shannon's right back out there,
yes,
Coach.
Yes, she is. Yes.
Quick little Band-Aid and send her back out.
Good for her.
It's a tough player.
And as we've indicated in several other matches, great pace.
Yes.
Wonderful pace.
She's going to be quite the welcome returning player next year.
Oh, you bet, your first-year player? Wow. Yeah, I'm not sure if the fans are aware or not, but she actually plays for the coach, Joe Muldoon, in the Peterborough City ladies team, so he's obviously very used to her and has asked her and indeed noticed that now that she's making diagonal runs when in the front striking position, she's contributing even more than she did in the past. So,
ooh. Ball into the Trent end. That's Curti running after it. Ooh. Kick to the inside. And out of danger. So that was Jennifer Palace clearing the ball out to the side. And Nipissing's Struthers.
What we noticed from the booth here yesterday in the Laurentian game was that Sarah Batley was open on many, many occasions on the left flank here, particularly in the first half. And she did a tremendous job defensively. But she was not utilized at all in attack, which I think you'll see will change in today's match.
So Nipissing now with the ball.
And one that...
Ooh, that's a tight call to make.
I would think it is.
But
not necessarily agreeing with.
Natasha Struthers now will kick the free kick. And it is a direct kick, it looks like. So let's see...
McGregor
up for the ball and she... Oh!
Good heavens.
Bad bounce. But it is blown down. Did that cross the line?
I don't believe it.
But
no.
McGregor does look injured. She's okay.
No, she's back up again. Good. This is a goal kick.
So a little bit of a tight
free
call.
Kick. Yeah.
I guess because danger to the goalies, they blew it down.
They protect goalkeepers now. They really do.
which is
any collisions with goalkeepers now are pretty well called. It's just the way it is in these days.
Selkirk collected up by Erica Dixon. There's Struthers again to Dixon.
And immediate pressure. I like that. I really do like that very much.
It's Catherine Monroe that's putting that pressure on that side.
And she's changing it, trying to change it to the far flank. There. Oh, I love it. Play the ball out. Well
Snook.
Done.
Snook.
Well done.
It's McPherson, but it got stripped. Great defense there by Jen Paulus.
These players are progressing in so much. Ooh. Their technique and their skill level is just...
There's O'Brien now looking no worse for wear.
I don't know why the linesman put a flag up here.
I'm not sure. Ooh. Tough kick.
An effort at goal.
And there's an injury now. It's always tough when you go for those 50-50 balls and you...
The best thing to do with 50-50 balls is win them. Get stuck. As a coach said, I look for that so much. It's not the necessary technique. It's the challenge. It's the effort. It's the courage to get stuck in and win it. It's the late person that gets injured, not the one that goes in first. That's the way I've noticed it anyway. So
don't back down from them.
Get stuck in for sure, and early as possible. We're still playing four in the back, that's for sure.
Maybe with the pressure that's been on, the coach decided not to switch it up yet?
I think it's a bit early yet. Things are going on fairly well.
So Nipissing,
putting pressure on.
There's Forrester with the steal. Tries to chip it up to Batley, but just couldn't get it to go.
Sarah Batley had a tremendous match yesterday. Paulus. As I said, particularly in the first half defensively because she wasn't utilized. Offensively, she certainly should have been, though. That's for sure.
Ball rolls to the flank and out.
To a Trent throw-in.
Trent with the throw-in.
Well done. Good throw.
Excellent. Brian stays on side.
Yes, and did you notice the diagonal run she had? That's how she got there, which is excellent. Well done.
Block shot.
Just knock it. Man on. Man on.
Uh-oh. Curti now.
No.
A little bit
no,
of pressure.
No.
Back to McGregor. Sends the ball up. Forrester sends the ball to the open corner. It's too far for anybody.
Yeah, is that going for a throw-in or a goal kick? Throw-in.
Throw-in.
but it's pretty obvious already that they're trying to use the flanks.
Now, to me... I would have sent O'Brien for the run on that corner. She might not have made it, but at least it's...
Yeah, well, it happened so quickly. It was very hard and difficult from Shannon's position to read that was going to go that deep. Obviously, I'm a fan of Shannon O'Brien. I'm a fan of each of our players, quite honestly. As a defender, as a player who is a defender, I really appreciate the defense and attack, so...
O'Brien now in the corner with a little bit of pressure.
She'll try and play it off of them, likely. Yes, she has. Not just a quick player, but an intelligent player as well.
Curti now for the throw-in. Let's see how long this throw-in is going to be here, Coach. Look at
My
that.
Goodness. My goodness, eh?
Larkin now.
Putting pressure on. Still putting pressure on. Well done. That's Emily Larkin, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Forrester lost the ball. Maybe I think the girls might be inspired by the Trent boys game yesterday that was a little gritty, a little hard fought, but nonetheless
strike it.
Exciting.
Why not? Yes. Good. Well done. Taking their chances. Well, we seem to be playing a little bit downhill here, which is great. I love to play in the other team's end.
Safer that way.
And they're back third. You're doing fine. Now the coach looks for, are we going to win goal kicks? Hopefully we are. And look at the shape. We're in good shape here. Excellent.
They've pushed up, it seems, too.
Yes, exactly.
Short goal kick. O'Brien is there. Forster now.
Forster, well done.
Well, good tough play by Forster.
Good idea. Very good idea.
Couldn't get to Monroe.
And Trent throw again. Now, I would delay my run here and let her throw the ball into space so that she can get there onto the ball as opposed to receiving the ball directly.
Catch the ball as you're running as opposed to.
Oh, exactly. Yes. Mm-hmm.
So Curdy now is getting another throw in.
My goodness. Again, this girl can throw a ball further than I can kick it.
I think she hits the weights.
Perhaps. Look at that.
Look, great throw in right into the penalty
That's
area.
Great. We must take advantage of that. We simply must. Well done. Look at the great pressure in their back third. Deep in their back third. And look what the position Emily Larkin is taking up here in the middle. That's exactly the right place where she should be.
Throw in.
And if it comes there, Emily, for goodness sakes, have a go. I think Emily Larkins.
Larkin, yep.
Has 1 year left.
She's a third-year player.
So I'm not sure if she's going to do the fifth year or not.
She could do a fifth-year victory lap. You might as well.
I hope she does.
Be a great addition to the team.
I'm a fan of hers as well.
She plays very hard, very tough.
And the shortest lady with the highest vertical in the team.
Yes.
Unbelievable.
Oh. And the ball does roll out in the flank, and it'll be a Trent throw-in.
And they're still at 4-4-2.
Emily now. Ball being worked up the flank here and kicked. Trent now working the ball up the flank. O'Brien going for a run.
1v1. Good pressure, very good pressure. And we win their ball out. I always like that.
Great pressure by the Trent girls here.
Like I say, Brendan, we're playing downhill here so far. That's great stuff. And what it does, it gives Trent players the confidence in them to say, well, wait a minute now, we're in range a heck of a lot here.
If you're playing on your toes, opposed on your heels, right?
Let's get a result from this, for sure. Good point, son.
It's easier to continue the push than push back, so.
Yes. Let's get the ball, switch the ball again back off to the right flank. We've done well from here as well. But every game we watch, you and I, son, darn balls on that far side so much. Winning the balls first time. Very good. And everybody's dropping.
Nipissing here with some pressure for the cross. Nice defense by the Trent player.
Very well done. Very, very well done.
Trent now working the ball out.
Yeah.
Nipissing is able to counter. Long boot.
Yeah, got
to
be keepers.
Stopped easily by Sarah.
Well done. Sarah McGregor is another one that is showing great progress in terms of her ability to save balls and distribution-wise as well. So that's always good to see.
Great confidence, too. She's able to, in some of the other games we've seen where they've been absolutely just blown out, she has the poise and the self-confidence to keep her head up no matter what.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Now, which is so important in that position.
Exactly.
Goalkeepers, wow.
It's like they say, look good, feel good, play good whenever you're a goalie, so.
Can I use that?
Yeah, of course.
Excellent, son. What a day.
But it's nice. A little bit of wind, but I mean, I'll take wind over rain. And
every time.
A little pressure for the ball.
See if we can win this ball. The last one, we won the last kick by the goalkeeper.
Now, this is keepers a little short. I've been thinking that if I was to kick the ball to go a little high or maybe...
That's what teams are doing against us. When we're conceding goals, it's mostly high balls.
Larkin out for the run. Look at her go.
And she'll shepherd this ball out for sure.
That girl probably has 5, maybe 6 inches on Larkin, and she was able to outrun her to the ball. Like,
well, she was shielding the ball there, not letting the player get to it. So that's always good. And the goal, and Sarah's taking her own goal kicks today. Oh, knocked in the back of the head. Play the ball out. Head injuries are call for a stop, an immediate stop in the match. If it's a foot or a knee or an ankle, something like a leg injury, sometimes the referees don't have to stop the play. But head injury, they really do have to.
Is that part of the new procedures now for concussions and everything?
Understanding, yes, particularly when people are so concerned about concussions. So
I remember talking to Candace, the trainer of the Trent team, and explaining her a story that I had where I got bopped in the head and basically shook it off and kept going. And she gave me a little bit of an earful for doing that, citing, you know, concussions.